The Formula One circus has made its way to the southern coast of Portugal this week, and it's preparing for what I expect to be a terrific race here in Portimão. So Portimão features 15 turns over the course of its 2.9 mile length. 9 are right-handers, 6 are to the left, and this is a track with a lot of uphill action, which only accentuates the importance of getting those exits right, especially at turn 4, where a good line can present opportunities to pass on the way into turn 5. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are 3 main things to worry about there, Crofty. Positioning, awareness, and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Midas lines up on pole position, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Hamilton, Sergio Perez, and Norris, Leclerc, Sainz, Ricciardo, and Fernando Alonso, Gasly, Ocon, Yuki Tsunoda, and Vettel, Stroll, Giovinazzi, Kimi Raikkonen, and George Russell, Latifi, Alesi, Mick Schumacher, and Nikita Mazepin. And now it's time to head down to the track.
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish. Okay, go through all the gears if you can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool though, so don't go too high with the revs. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch.
Verstappen has just put up the fastest lap of the race so far.
tyre concerns at the moment, just focus on the driving. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the hards. Norris has just put up the fastest lap of the race so far. Giuliano is in the pits. Giuliano in the pits. Pit window open. Let's box this lap.
go, go.
Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Yellow flag. Someone's come off ahead of you. There's a yellow flag ahead. Green flag. Job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far.
You're losing a small amount of time to the car behind. Keep pushing.
The fastest lap of the race. Keep this up.
Thank you.
The car behind is dropping back by about 0.3 a lap. Verstappen has just put up the fastest lap of the race so far. Five laps of fuel remaining. Verstappen has just put up the fastest lap of the race so far.
tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them.
The car behind is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. Three laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Job, you've done everything we wanted today.
So after a day of mixed fortunes up and down the field, we bring today's race to a close. Tell me, Ant, how did they manage to achieve this win?
Well, I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out on the track was today, speed. I know it sounds like an obvious thing to say, Crofty, but fast cars win races, and we saw that today with our winner.
Here comes your top three making their way down to the podium for what can only be described as a fantastic day for Formula One. Let's see what effect this result has had on the driver's standings. Midas takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Daniel Ricciardo certainly impressed me today. An incredible